As long as we watch out for coolant levels and give it proper maintenance and care, these engines should very easily last 250 plus thousand miles. Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Automotive here. Today I am talking about common problems and reliability issues with Ford's 2.5 liter Duratec engine. The 2.5 Duratec is a 2.5 liter inline four engine that was used on a number of Ford, Lincoln, and Mercury vehicles from 2009 all the way until 2019. It was used in things like the Ford Escape and the Ford Fusion, as well as the Lincoln MKZ and the Mercury Milan. It was also even used in the Australian version of the Ford Ranger. The 2.5 Duratec was actually engineered in conjunction with Mazda, and so it's actually known also as the Mazda L engine or the L5-VE. Mazda used it in a number of their cars in North America and overseas in things like the Mazda 3, the Mazda 6, the CX-7, and the Mazda Tribute. So the good news about the 2.5 Duratec or the Mazda L is that it was very over-engineered for the amount of power that it produces. The Duratec engine maxes out at about 175 horsepower, but in a lot of configurations only produces about 156 horsepower. And so those power levels for a naturally aspirated 2.5 liter motor are very modest. So because we've got very modest power levels and strong engineering with the materials that this engine was built with, we have really good durability and very good reliability. The 2.5 Duratec is a virtually bulletproof motor. It was very difficult to find a whole lot of problems with this engine, so we really only have one problem with the engine itself to talk about, and then everything else on my list here is kind of just things not related to the Duratec motor, but related to the cars and the vehicles that these engines were used in. With that being said, let's get to the one and really kind of only problem on these 2.5 Duratecs, and that is coolant consumption. The 2.5 Duratecs experience coolant consumption for somewhat of an unknown reason. A lot of the thought is that the coolant consumption comes from engine block porosity, which is a little bit more of an advanced topic. So the most important thing to know is that these engines consume coolant at a higher rate than other engines. So naturally what happens over time as these engines are consuming the coolant is you end up low on coolant, and so you have to top off every once in a while to make sure your coolant levels are high enough so that your cooling system is operating properly. So this isn't really a huge issue. It's more so something to be aware of and to know about, just because you might see a low coolant warning light on your dashboard. And overall, it's a good idea to check your coolant levels on these engines every probably 6 months or so, just to make sure you're not getting too low on coolant, because while this isn't a problem, running low on coolant ultimately can lead to serious problems. So what we want to do is make sure we've got enough coolant in there so that we don't run into overheating issues, because overheating can then lead to a lot of expensive to fix problems or even catastrophic engine failure. Overall, not a problem as long as we make sure we don't run low on coolant. As long as we do that, these engines are extremely reliable, and that really is the only thing that is a common or a known issue on these engines. For the sake of not having one problem to talk about in this whole video, I found a couple other things that are worthy of mentioning. An important thing here is the 6-speed transmissions that Ford used with the 2.5 Duratec engine. The transmissions used in the Fusion, the Escape, and the Milan are 6-speed automatics, and they are generally not considered the greatest transmissions that Ford manufactured. They are known to experience transmission fluid leaks coming from the output shaft seal. These fluid leaks are known to start occurring as frequently as about 70,000 miles. Ultimately, what can happen is you run low on transmission fluid, and then that ends up causing excessive wear and tear on all of the gears inside of the transmission. And so the transmissions on these vehicles do not tend to last as long, certainly, as the engines will, and transmission problems are a little bit more commonplace of a problem. In addition to fluid leaks, there also is an issue with the TCM and the PCM kind of getting out of alignment that can cause rough shifting or delayed shifting between gears. And while these transmission problems have been seen across all years, it does seem that it is most impacting the 2012 to 2014 models. And so if you have a 2012 to 2014 or you're looking at one, just be aware that the transmissions in these ones seem to be a little bit worse than the ones that come in all of the other Fusion, Escapes, and Milans. And then the third problem, which is going to be specific to the Ford Fusions and the Ford Escapes, is power steering failure. Ford switched from a hydraulic power steering setup to a fully electronic power assisted steering system known as EPAS or EPAS. While this simplifies the power steering setup, it obviously adds a lot more failure points because everything is handled electronically. So ultimately, what causes the power steering system to fail is on these newer power steering setups, there is a torque sensor, and the torque sensor is what is known to suddenly fail, which causes the whole power steering system to go out. Fortunately, there was a recall that replaces the torque sensor because the torque sensor is located on the steering column, and so the whole steering column actually has to be removed to replace it. So if you didn't get that recall done, or you have to have this issue taken care of outside of the recall, it can be a little bit expensive to get it done just because a lot of parts have to be removed to go ahead and access this sensor. So ultimately, the 2.5 Duratec is an extremely reliable engine. As long as we watch out for coolant levels and give it proper maintenance and care, these engines should very easily last 250 plus thousand miles. It's just worth noting that the transmissions that some of them are paired to probably aren't gonna last that same lifespan either. These engines themselves are extremely strong and bulletproof, just Ford paired them with a bad transmission in some cases. But that's not a knock on this engine. This engine is extremely strong from a reliability standpoint. So that wraps it up for our video on reliability and problems with the 2.5 Duratec. If you guys appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for our future content.